Visceral fat is the fat found deep inside your abdominal cavity. It surrounds important organs like your stomach, liver, and intestines. And although some levels of visceral fat are healthy and serve as a way to protect your organs, too much visceral fat can lead to serious health issues like diabetes and heart disease. In this video, I put together three things you can do starting today to tackle visceral fat that doesn't involve exercise. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I would love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. If you really like the content, then consider subscribing. Also, if you guys are on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get straight into it. There is a reason why visceral fat is called hidden fat, because you can be skinny and thin, but still pack on a decent amount of visceral fat around the abdominal region. Just because you can't see the fat doesn't mean your organs are not surrounded by it. And fat cells do more than just simply store energy and keep us warm. They also produce hormones and inflammatory substances. For example, visceral adipose tissue produces more pro-inflammatory cytokines like TNF-alpha and IL-6, and less adiponectin. And that's a problem because these changes impact insulin resistance and puts us at a risk of developing atherosclerosis, which we know is what thins out and hardens our arteries, affecting our blood flow and circulation. And it doesn't just stop there. There is a theory about visceral fat called the portal theory that explains how visceral fat releases inflammatory markers and fatty acids that end up traveling down the portal vein into the liver, which in turn may cause fat buildup in the liver, making the liver become more insulin resistant, which leads to type 2 diabetes. And a good way to illustrate visceral fat is by comparing apples to pears. And what do I mean? Let me show you. You see, visceral fat makes the belly stick out or gives a person an apple shape. So you'll store more fat in the upper region, belly and chest. But if you're a pear shaped, you'll tend to store the fat in the lower extremities, for example, hips, thighs, and buttocks, as subcutaneous fat. For a quick measurement, you want to take one of these. For men, aim for a waist circumference of less than 40 inches or 102 centimeters. And for women, aim for less than 35 inches or 89 centimeters. We tend to base a lot of our results off a scale, which is not reliable. It's helpful, but you shouldn't base your results only on a scale, which we know does fluctuate about 5 or 6 pounds per day. And remember, you want to measure from the top of the waist bone and don't suck in your gut. You want to relax and stick it out and take an average of 2 to 3 measurements to get somewhat of a baseline. So go ahead and do that now. It can be uncomfortable, especially if you've never done it before, but you can pause the video and write down what those results are so you can make this video a practical one. Don't let it be another video you watch and forget. So now that we have some background, let me give you some good news before I get into the three tips. And although you can't directly target a certain area of fat in the body, for example, only the belly or only the flappy arms or the double chin, what we do know is that visceral fat can be easier to lose than subcutaneous fat. Yes, that's correct. Easier to lose. This is because it's believed that it metabolizes quicker and your body can get rid of it in sweat and in urine. And although exercise is a huge takeaway to get the ball rolling, even if it's those short bits of walking, my first tip that doesn't include exercise is avoiding those sneaky trans fats that can still be out there. Now, if you're in the US, the FDA has banned them. But here's the catch. Some products label their products trans fat free as long as there are fewer than 0.5 grams of these fats per serving. And if you're outside the US, trans fats can be part of your daily diet and you might not even know it. A good tip is don't eat foods that have any partially hydrogenated items on the ingredients list. Cakes, cookies, frozen pizzas, and pies. Check those labels. And by far, one of the most interesting studies on trans fats causing visceral fat change was actually done on monkeys over 6 years, and they found that trans fat led to visceral fat even in the absence of caloric excess and were associated with, guess what? Insulin resistance. The second tip to lose visceral fat without exercise is to increase your soluble fiber intake. Only 5% of men and 9% of women are getting the recommended daily amount of dietary fiber. That means more than 90% of the US aren't getting enough fiber. And how much is enough? This chart shows a good representation. 38 grams a day for men and 25 grams a day for women. And if you're 51 or older, then it's lower to 30 grams a day for men and 21 grams a day for women. And in this study with 1,114 people, increasing soluble fiber intake by 10 grams daily reduced the risk of visceral fat gain by up to 3.7%, which is awesome. And the last tip to lose visceral fat without exercise is reduce your stress levels. Not eliminate stress, because stress is important for survival and we all need stress in order to get out of dangerous situations, but not everyone can turn off these responses when that stress is no longer needed. Some research shows us that this may even be harder for women who already have a large waist in proportion to their hips, which we refer to as the hip to waist ratio, which is another marker of visceral fat. These women tend to produce more cortisol when stressed and can lead to central fat. And the thing with cortisol is that it doesn't distinguish between physical and mental stress. So having physical illnesses like diabetes can already drive up cortisol levels, becoming a vicious cycle. So it's important that you give yourself this time, if you haven't already, to find out what works for you today. Whether that is deep breathing techniques, finding a hobby you enjoy like gardening, writing in a journal, getting adequate sleep, finding a support system, daily exercise, and trying out a whole food plant-based diet can be a few changes that can actually help. And although there are obviously more ways to tackle down visceral fat, which I encourage you to write down what they are in the comment section below if you have any ideas, so we can actually have a discussion, I do believe you should also balance this out with other lifestyle changes like aerobic exercise, increasing your probiotics, limiting your alcohol intake and quitting smoking, as well as intermittent fasting, which I will discuss soon.